everybody. Very good morning. How are you?
Good morning.
Hello,
sir.
We're
fine, and you?
Today, we are going to discuss from our Nelson book, that means today is our language. Nelson book, page number 71. The name of the chapter is My Mother Saw a Dancing Bear. Okay. My mother saw a dancing bear. First, let me read the poem so that you guys can understand it, and then we will do some work on the poem. Without book, you cannot understand anything, and you cannot do the work what I will give you on the worksheet. Okay. Look at the poem. My mother saw a dancing bear. My mother saw a dancing bear by the school yard, a day in June. The keeper stood with chain and bar. How is your book? Nelson book.
PCT, Chobi.
PC Nelson book? What are you saying? Take the book.
Sir, I don't have the book. I just have pick.
What of the book means? Have you lost the book?
No, I don't have the book right now.
What are you saying? By the school year, a day in July, a day in June, the keeper stood with chain and bar, and whistle pipe, and played a tune, and blue lifted up his head, and lifted up his dusty feet, and all the children laughed to see it caper in the summer heat. The worst as for the queen, it died. They watched it march, they watched it all, they heard the keeper as he cried, now roly-poly somersault. Now come to the worksheet of the discussion. You have to find out something. Look at this. Here is some more work. Choose the best answer. Just you have to write down the answer in your copy. Number 8. When the post wife saw the dancing bear, she was in a zoo, schoolyard, a forest. Okay, just to write down the answer to the one from the book.
So should we write the answer now?
What are you saying?
Yeah,
right, start writing.
Should we write the answer now?
Yeah, on the answer, yeah, now. Start writing the answer. So your time has finished here. Now it's my turn to write the answer. Look at here. Number 1, what they are saying. Number 1, I think the answer. When the boy saw the dancing bear, she was in school year. Okay. The dancing bear visited the town in June. The keeper played whistle pipe. The bear had to march. The baby cup was for money. So, have you written the answer, everybody? Everyone, Fahima, everyone? All the answers correct? Come on. Great. So, come to the next question. There is a lot of work on this poem. Look at here, number B. Let me the next one. Using thesaurus. What is the meaning of thesaurus? We can say. This is a very, very new word for you. Using thesaurus, explain these words. Okay, the meaning of thesaurus is dictionary. It's a new word for you, thesaurus, dictionary. So what you have to do, you have to, no need to take a dictionary because all the things are in the book. So you have to explain the words, what the poet said about the word. Whistle man, green, caper, somersault, begging, shaming. Okay, so look at here, I'm writing the answer, you guys will follow me. Come. here. Start writing with me. Philip Whistle Pipe. Whistle Man. Musical. And it will be, wait just a minute, it will not be some man, Whistle Pipe. Right? Musical instrument. Musical instrument. Be careful, right? How will you write in your copy? You have to write Whistle Pipe, then the meaning, okay? If you write only meaning, then during exam time, you will understand which meaning you have written. Green. Look at here. Green means what? Brown bear. Paper. Paper means crisp. That means jumping here and there. Somersault. You guys know what is somersault? Do you know what is somersault? In Bengali it is called dikbaji. That means jumping. Acrobatic. Begging, shaming, humiliate, listen. Next one is what they are saying. Look very carefully, everybody. Ariba, Fahima, Mashpi, are you there? Mashpi? Look here. What they are saying. Number. See that in the next one. Circle the unexpressed vowel. Look at here. Number A. Parliament. Parliament. P-A-R-L-I-A-N-E-N-T, Parliament. But we are not here using, we are not pronouncing I here. It's not an I. Look very carefully, this is a very important thing. Parliament. We never say Parliament. We say Parliament. We don't use I. So I is unexpressed here. So that means I is not using. We are not expressing, we are not pronouncing I. Parliament, not parliament. So I is unexpressed vowel here, and you have to circle I like this. Okay, just a minute. I am circling so that you can understand. Okay, you have to circle I like this. Got it? So I is our unexpressed vowel. So in the rest of all, what you have to do? The rest of all, you have to find out the unexpressed vowel, and if you find, then you have to circle it. Okay, so number B is religious, estuary, D is vowel, E is mineral, F is literature. You have to find out the unexpressed vowel, and then you have to circle it. Hurry up, start. Thank you. Helga complete? Karina complete? So look, what I want to do now, I will circle and I will find out the unspelled vowel here. Look at here. Number A, I say programming. Here I did unspelled. So number B, religious. Which one will be unspelled vowel I want to
G, I think it will be G also.
Which one? Here is it. Which one? The I beside A or the I beside G? Which one?
I
only. Is I. Religious. Religious. We never say religious. We say religious. So here I is unexpressed. Okay? Circle I. Must be you say. Number C. It's true. In the sentence, which one is unexpressed?
Sure, it will be U A.
Sorry?
U A.
Here, it says true. So A is unexpressed here. Okay, A. Circle A. Vowel. Here, E is unexpressed. Number E. Fahima said, which one is unexpressed here?
Yeah.
Which one is unexpressed? Here is the vowel, I, E, A. Which one is unexpressed?
E.
Yes, it's a mean word, not it's a mean word, it's a mean word. Okay, so E is unexpressed here. And number A. Number A, you will say, which one is unexpressed?
E, R.
Only one. R is not vowel.
R
is consonant. So here, our A is unexpressed. It's a literature, not literature. No, sorry, it is wrong. Literature. Here, E is unexpressed. E. Literature, not literature. The point should be literature. Okay. Got it. Come to the next point. Next topic. Look at here. What is this? Write the correct spelling for these words. Here is some wrong spelling. You have to write down correctly. Okay. You have to write down the spelling correctly. I want to see. Here is 6 wrong spelling words. So I'm giving you 5 minutes. Hurry up. At the last moment, I will write. Start writing. Wrong spelling, you have to correct it. Move on. So as you have completed, now it's my turn to write. Look at here whether you were typed or not. I'm writing. Number A. Omar say, I want to hear. Nampa waiter. Huh? Then number B. Number B is wrong. It is written. Let the tone. If you use a great tone, then go away tone. If you are wrong, then write it. Number C, it is here written medicine. It is a medicine. Number D, it is written marriage. It is a marriage. Okay. Number A. Here is written funeral. It will be funeral. Funeral. It is written here business. It will be business. Right here. Hurry up. Time is going. Complete? Fahima, Haliba, Omar? Omar, you complete? So, our class time is finished here. Are you ready? Stay safe and get ready for the next class. See you later.